Greetings, Guardians. My name is Bife here. Sorry for the long break. I was taking some time off over the Thanksgiving holiday. First time in America, spending time with my girlfriend, and doing Thanksgiving for the first time. For those of you who can't tell, I'm British, and we don't celebrate Thanksgiving. So, yeah, brand new experience. But we're gonna jump right back into everything, seeing as now I'm back. And Curse of Osiris is right around the corner, so there's lots that we need to cover, and I thought that this topic was something we really did need to jump into because it's something that's really advanced, very interesting, and relevant to basically the entirety of the Vex. So the Vex are widely known for being one of the more advanced alien races in Destiny. Their weapons are quite literally futuristic space lasers. However, the most intriguing aspect for me is the fact that the Vex are capable of traveling through time, with the result of a rapid response to any incursion that we might make, and a swift end to those not so well prepared for their rebuke. However, the question has remained for the longest time: how exactly do the Vex pull off the feat of time travel? Today, I want to try and provide a few answers to all of this, but before I do this, it's worth noting two things. First of all, you may want to brush up a little on your knowledge of the Vex. For this, I'm recommending that people take a look at my videos on the Vault of Glass and on Vex Mind Fluid, aka Vex Milk. So yeah, get all of that in your brain if you want. It'll get you up to date on everything we know for the most part on the Vex. If you want to just jump in, don't worry, we'll begin in a second. Secondly, I would note, a lot of this, whilst it is backed up by statements given in the game and in lore, is still theoretical. There are lots of things that we do not know, and it's very much worth noting that times can change all of this lore. So do go ahead and take everything I say with the most minor pinch of salt. However, I do still feel quite confident about stating that most of this is quite definitive. So, let's begin. The most important thing to initially note about the Vex is their ability as a race to quite literally be in two places at once. You see, the Vex is best described as a giant collective consciousness. The reason why you see so many Vex mages out there with varying kinds of mind in their name is that they are all representative of different forms of processing. Brachion, the Genesis mind, for example, is responsible for the creation of a Vex world on Io. Whereas the Vex mind Theosion back in Destiny 1, or the restorative mind, was responsible for the recreation of any Vex minds lost on Venus. This collective consciousness is always working towards that singular goal of the Vex, which is the eventual domination of the universe and the occurrence of a reality where all the universe belongs to them. So with that said and done, the Vex need to be able to have influence in all times to bring about this reality. Hence, the need for time travel. Now, back to the question of how they do it. The simple answer to all of this is that they travel through the Vex gate system, but for me that's never a satisfactory answer. That's a little bit like saying space magic is why we can summon a Nova Bomb. And whilst I'm happy to go ahead and say, yeah, sure, space magic is space magic, the question of time travel, ever since we got the smallest hints of being able to unravel it, really did require a bit more explanation. It felt like a bit of a cop-out if we didn't get a real answer. I've had this theory of how the Vex might be capable of time travel in their gate system for quite some time, but it wasn't really something I could confirm until Destiny 2 was released. You see, there's an adventure on Nessus known as Hack the Planet, and in this adventure we send Failsafe into the Vex Collective network, and it's one of the most revealing adventures thus far because of one line at the very end, and it tells us about the nature of time within the Vex network. Plus, it tells us about the Vex as a force within the universe. So I'm just going to go ahead and play that adventure and the relevant parts to it so that you can understand what's going on, but listen to all of this, it gets really fascinating.
Hey team, I know how we can hook Failsafe up to the Nessus core and mine all the data we could ever want. Just help me place these beacons and I'll explain. These beacons should allow us to hook Failsafe into the Nessus core. Think of all the data she could pull.
It is a proactive and clever plan, friendly ghost.
I still think it's a bad idea.
This will work, trust me. You know how I usually hack and scan stuff for us?
I do.
This one's all you.
How fun.
core is open. Get ready, failsafe.
I am practicing my best Vex impressions. Please do not let them capture me, Captain.
Just treat it like tightrope walking. Don't think about it.
You're not helping.
You can do this, failsafe. I believe in you.
If they kill me, I will haunt your shell. I have interfaced with the Nessus core.
See? Easy. Grab everything that's not nailed down.
The Vex are attempting to impede my progress. There should be a conflux nearby. Please stabilize it for me. Thank you, Captain. Now eliminate those data cubes. They contain security protocols that are blocking my progress.
You're a pro. I knew this could work.
The Vex are fighting back. I have marked other confluxes for stabilization. Destroy the cubes they generate.
Failsafe, the Vex have sent a mind after us. Failsafe, any updates? Okay, so she's been captured by the Vex. I'm so sorry. I can fix this. Get me the data core from that mind. Failsafe's gotta be in here somewhere. Help me get rid of the interference from these confluxes, and I should be able to lock onto her location. Got her. Locked her in a cube construct. Take out the Vex and we'll free her. Hope it's not too late.
Speaking with a fellow prisoner.
A decade? It didn't take us that long.
Time must work differently within the network. He was a very good listener. It's a shame I couldn't take him with me. He showed me a myriad of potentialities for this galaxy. How the Vex intend to shape them, I will share with your vanguard.
I'm so sorry I put you through that.
But you did. And I never forget those who wronged me.
Now, with all that said and done, that last line about how it took Failsafe 10 years of time within the Vex network before she was released, whereas for us it's realistically more like a few minutes, that's what's really important. I'm going to go ahead and make one really big assumption here as well. Namely, that the Vex gate system and the collective consciousness of the Vex are predominantly within a separate dimension. Sounds pretty radical, but this is where the theory comes in. To refer back to the Book of Sorrows, Crota, the son of Oryx, at one point opens a wound within the dimension of Oryx's sword realm. This crosses directly with the Vex and allows them to invade by doing so. Now, sword realms are in their own dimension in their own. They are sword spaces that are cysts in the universe. They are pocket dimensions. And it implies that there's some kind of other dimension aside from our own. I like to refer to our dimension, Earth, Venus, Mars, Mercury, all of that typical stuff, as the Materium. And I believe that when we go on the Crota's End raid within Destiny 1, and when we have those moments where we cross into an Ascendant realm, that we are actually entering what I like to refer to as the Immaterium, or the Netherverse. Keep in mind, that in itself requires its own hub of explanation. But realistically, if the Vex do manage to cross over into a Hive Ascendant realm because Crota tries to force a hole in it, then yeah, you all of a sudden have a little bit of proof that they are indeed two linked dimensions. More so than that, there's Bungie constantly hinting at stuff like this. Take a look at Crota's grimoire card, and all of a sudden you start to see this odd line that's placed at the end without any real rhyme or reason, stating that the relationship between the Vex collective gate system and the Hive Netherworlds is not well explained, or words to that effect. Now, with that in mind, Bungie never places text like that without any kind of prior meaning or use for it. So you can almost take that as some kind of tiny tacit confirmation that there is a link, it's just poorly explained. So, why does all of this fit together? Well, let's start using some diagrams. Imagine that this line here is time in our dimension, this white line going from left to right. For the moment, we're going to call that, as I stated, the materium. We experience time at only one point, this point here in the center. That for us is, for the sake of this diagram, the present, and we can only see what's happening and act within that one moment. The Vex, however, are a collective consciousness, where every frame, machine, and Radiolorian particle gives them insight as a collective presence across all times where they are found. But they can only do this on a major scale if time is running at a different speed within their home dimension. Whilst it's grossly oversimplifying the diagram, for the sake of explanation, I think the best way to explain it is like this. This squiggly line up and down on the diagram technically is longer than time in our dimension. It passes at a faster rate, but there's more of it there, is the best way to explain it. So a small amount of distance that one might see within our dimension being only 10 minutes might, for the Vex, translate to an incredibly long amount of time, potentially up to 10 years. That kind of explains why there's that difference where Failsafe has been trapped for 10 years and we rescue her after such a short amount of time within our dimension. This, of course, is all very weird, and this relates to the ideas that are employed with string theory, and it's, yeah, at that point it gets to the point of complication where I don't want to explain it further because it... too much. Too much for one video, but more importantly, it just starts to get bogged down in theory. And keep in mind that even string theory itself, talking about parallel dimensions and all that, is one of its own kind of theories, and it's not really well proven. It's one of those things where we need to just delve deeper into the science of the universe to understand it. So yeah, there's that. But realistically, you have two great examples here of how the Vex might well be connected. How they might have their own new dimension, and how it might have time that travels at a different speed. So yeah, on this diagram, you can maybe understand how the Vex gate system functions, although this is incredibly simplified, as I've said so many times. Wherever the curved line intersects with the normal straight line are points at which the two universes can cross. Those are the points at which one might find Vex time gates, for example. So, yeah, that explains the point at which they can cross over. And realistically, any point at which they just appear out of thin air, I'm willing to put down to teleportation. You've got to keep in mind that the Vex are still capable of teleportation and transmat much as Guardians are, but realistically, being able to jump in and out of timelines is a feature of them appearing out of Vex gates. That, I think, is the real crux of it. So the two should not be confused. Vex appearing out of the thin air should not be thought of as Vex time traveling necessarily. Although, again, I may be misunderstanding that because, heck, look back at House of Wolves. Apparently, Skolas was pulling all of the House of Wolves through time and they appear out of thin air. So who knows, maybe there's a ton of intersections and the Vex can just appear at will from any time. Yeah, there's a whole load of stuff that we still don't understand, as I said at the very beginning, but here we can at least get our head around the basic concept. They have their own dimension, and time passes at a different speed within that dimension, allowing them to take the long way round whilst realistically not taking that much time at all. Now, admittedly, there is an aspect to this that isn't so easily portrayed by the diagram, which is how the flow of time works. You see, the Vex of the future can travel back in time, and that then speaks volumes about how complex the gate system really is. It can't be accurately portrayed by this diagram, but I feel like that's the most simple way of showing it off. Time can't flow backwards. Realistically, there must be a ton of intersections in our dimension. It's gonna be better to show something like this in three dimensions, but at the same time, it's then just gonna look completely crazy. You'd have time literally looping back and forth with that second dimension, and yeah, I genuinely have no idea how that would end up looking, but it looks a little bit crazy if you just think about it. Regardless, this does hopefully give you an appreciation for how mind-bending the Vex are in terms of their capabilities. They're using alternate dimensions to travel back and forth through time. And not only that, if you look at all the things that have happened within the Vault of Glass, it's clear that they must be traveling through other realities in order to do this. Our reality perhaps isn't the central one. It may be the one that they're trying to eventually push forward into some end state where they win, but at the same time, they've been cutting off realities where they fail within the Vault of Glass for Lord knows how long. So, Yeah, mind-boggling and scientifically a little bit scary. The Vex are just one of those forces of the universe, like a roving black hole, where if you try and comprehend it, it just either gives you some kind of crazy Lovecraftian feel of doom and a little bit of gloom, or alternatively, you're sitting there and just, you can't possibly even fathom what's going on, and you just sort of get left there in stupor. So yeah, that's kind of the theory behind how all of this works. Too long, didn't listen? The Vex travel through different dimensions in order to reach different places, because the dimensions all have time passing at different speeds. So yeah, that's the somewhat crazy theory behind all of this, and hopefully it's been somewhat well transferred to you guys. If this was poorly explained, please do let me know in the comments section, because I'd love to clarify all of this. It's really a damn shame if that is the case, by the way, because, man, this is hopefully something really interesting for you guys. And if it's not, then heck, maybe time travel isn't a hot-button topic like I thought it would be. But even so, let me know what you think down in the comments section below. And if I've missed anything, because much as I said at the beginning, this is one of the more theoretical and poorly explained parts of the lore, and there is a hint here as to how it functions. It goes into Netherverse theory, which is something I've been thinking about for quite literally years. So yeah, tell me what you think down below. In addition, what other videos do you want me to cover before Curse of Osiris releases? I'll go ahead and try and compile a list for you guys. Recently, I was doing a lot of votes on Twitter, about a month ago actually, when we were looking for new content to cover. I think I'll resume that when I get some ideas from you guys here in the comments section, and we'll see what the more popular topics are. In addition, if you want to go ahead and get more Destiny content, then you can hit the subscribe button, or you can hit the bell next to subscribe, to turn on those email notifications so that you never miss a video. Also, if you want to support, adding a like is greatly appreciated. But of course, your viewership is quite enough for me. And in the meantime, my name has been My Name is Bife. Purudasya Arastra. I'll see you, Starside.